Hans, what is this?
Hey Jeff, this is a skeleton that we found in Pakistan. It's about 49 million years old.
Yeah, but what is it?
Oh, it's actually one of the earliest whales, one of the ancestors of whales. We call it Amblyopsetus natans, or the walking whale.
Yeah, a whale? This doesn't look anything like a whale. I mean, when you dug it up, how did you know it was a whale?
Yeah, you're right. It doesn't look much like a modern whale. And it was very frustrating when we dug it up. We took about 3 days to dig up the skeleton. The first part we found was the knee joint. Modern whales, of course, don't have knees. Only on the third day did we find the skull, and eventually I could get enough dirt and rock off of that to tell me what the animal was. And that was clear then from looking at the teeth and looking at the ear of the animal.
So what is it about the teeth and the ear?
Yeah, I can show you that better in the lab with the real fossils.
Okay. Oh, wait. You mean this isn't the real fossil?
Oh, no. This is a reconstruction of it. This is plastic. The real skeleton is lying in my lab. Scientists that want to see it usually want to handle each of the bones, so we couldn't put them together like this. Also, the real skeleton is very heavy, so you couldn't suspend it from four little wires like this.
Did you find all of it or just part of it?
And as common with fossils, we did not find all of it. We didn't find the tip of the snout. We only found part of the forelimb and part of the hind limb, and we did not find much of the tail.
Well, if you didn't find all of it, how did you build this? I mean, how do you know what to reconstruct?
Right. What you do is you look at closely related animals, and you use their shapes to infer what those parts should look like. And so for those animals, those parts are known, and that's what we use.
But I don't see any blowhole. I mean, whales have a blowhole.
That's true. Modern whales all have a blowhole, which it's clearly not in this guy, but we actually don't know where the nose opening is in this whale. But I can show you how we inferred that by going over and looking at some skulls.
Yeah, but why do you have to make it up anyways?
The reason is that if you show the partial skeleton to a general audience, they have a hard time imagining what the real animal would look like. If you look at this animal, you have an immediate sense of that. It sort of looks like a giant crocodile.
Well, that makes sense to me, but I'd still like to see the real fossil.
All right. Maybe we'll start by showing you the blowhole story. And all that's right. Over here.
Great, now we get to look at the blowholes.
So this is the skull of a pig, a modern pig, wild pig. And you see that in this animal, the nose opening is way at the front, at the tip of the snout, like it is in land mammals in general. Mm-hmm. Next to this is the skull of a modern dolphin, which is really a small relative of whales. And here you see that the nose opening is way on the forehead of the animal. And that's called the blowhole in whales. And so you see that the blowhole has moved all the way from the front in land mammals to the forehead in dolphins and whales. Then we've got this fossil whale from India. And this whale is called Remicunicetus. And here you see the brain case of the skull. This is the eye. And the nose opening in this whale is way in the front. You see there's a big distance between the eye and the nose is way in the front of this guy. This other fossil whale here, for this guy we did not find the brain case, which would have been in the back, but that's the space for the eye. And you see that here the nose opening is further back. It's not way at the tip of the snout here, but it has moved back already towards the eyes.
So this intermediate whale, the proto-seated, is about halfway between the tip and the eyes.
That's right. Amblyopsetus now is most similar to this whale, and that's why we reconstructed an Amblyopsetus nose opening in this particular spot.
Yeah, Amblyopsetus. You promised to show me the fossils, the real fossils of Amblyopsetus.
Yes, let's go to the lab and look at that.
Okay. Okay, so here it is, Jeff. Let's sit down here.
These are the real bones. They're beautiful. What an amazing fossil. This is the one that you found in Pakistan, but how big was the area that you found these in?
Yeah, it was actually sort of the same size as this table is, but it wasn't flat, it was vertical, so we had to dig quite deep to get at this thing. So It was sort of a frustrating experience to dig this guy up. It took us initially 3 days, and we found all these limb bones and ribs and vertebrae, but we didn't find the skull, so we actually didn't know what animal it was. I knew it was fossil seafloor because there were clams and there were snail shells, but I did not know which animal it was. And only on the third day, we found the skull.
All right, so how do you know this is a whale?
We know that this is a whale because of its ear. The first part of bone that we found that indicated that this was a whale is this. It's part of the ear of the whale.
It doesn't look anything like an ear.
That's true. It's really part of the ear, and it's part of the skull. So this bone is inside the head. It does have a function in hearing. Maybe I can explain it better if I show you this part in a modern whale. So here is the same part in a bowhead whale.
Much bigger.
Yes. So here you see that same bone, it's called a tympanic bone, and you see that that bone has in the center a cavity here, and it's basically bowl-shaped. On one side there is a really thick part, the wall of the bowl is really thick, that's called the involucrum. On the other side it's much thinner. The involucrum now is the part of the ear that's diagnostic for whales and their relatives, dolphins and porpoises, and it's also present in all fossil whales and not in other mammals. So that's a very diagnostic ear. If you look at the outside of this bone here, you also see that there's this funny squiggly part here. That's called the sigmoid process. That character is a little more tricky because it's present in all whales, fossil and recent, but it's also present in some animals that are not whales.
We're here to talk about Ambulocetus, not modern whales. So how did you identify this fossil as a whale?
Right. Hey guys, I'm here making some coffee. You want anything?
Hey, that's a nice t-shirt.
Oh, thanks.
Where'd you get it?
Oh, I got it at the bookstore, The Nook. You could get it at this email address, or there's a link to it on our Facebook page.
Okay, now back to that lump of bone.
Right, so this part, the first part that we found, that's just the involucrum of this bone, the thickened part. As we were digging further and cleaning it in the lab, we've actually found the other ear for the same whale, the left and the right ear. And now this looks a little more familiar. You see on one side here, the thick involucrum, then this skinny groove here, that's the cavity, making this the same bowl-shaped bone. And then on the outside, you also see that little crest of bone, the sigmoid process.
So I see that you identified this as a whale based on several features, the most important of which is the involucrum and the ear.
That's right.
And I wish it was all explained in a book.
Well, funny that you should say that, because I wrote such a book. There it is.
Have you gotten any feedback on it?
Oh yeah, my mom loves this book. So let's say that we are all going to read this book, learn about whale origins, and the next time you log on to YouTube, you'll get a quiz.